constitutes the mainstay of total revenue, and it is expected to account for 26.5% of total revenue and grants in 2010-2011. Overall, tax revenue is estimated at $20.4 billion in 2010-2011, compared to $22.2 billion collected in 2009-2010. While SACU revenues have fallen, domestic revenue outturn has remained resilient. Individual income tax, value-added tax, and mining company taxes displayed better performance amongst the domestic tax revenue streams. Now on the fiscal outlook front, revenue outlook. Total revenue and grants for 2011-2012 are projected at $28 billion, which constitutes a 24% increase from $22.5 billion estimated for 2010-2011. Tax revenue is expected to improve moderately over the MTF period due to improvements in commodity prices and mining activities. Total revenue and grants are expected to improve from 28.5% of GDP in 2011-2012 to 29.1% in 2012-2013 and 30.4% of GDP in 2013-2014. New trade agreements and a new SACU revenue sharing formula that could result in considerable decreases in revenue are on the horizon. A lower return on export due to currency appreciation is another medium-term risk that may exert pressure on revenue growth. In light of the above-mentioned risks and given public expenditure requirements, we will continue to aim at strengthening revenue collection. Government will further implement measures to broaden the revenue base by tapping alternative sources of revenue without compromising global and regional competitiveness. External grants. Grant support from our development partners in 2011-2012 will amount to $1.6 billion outside the State Revenue Fund and $230 million through the State Revenue Fund. This support covers a range of key intervention areas, primarily HIV/AIDS, the environment, education, infrastructure, and agriculture. In order to improve financial planning and accountability and ensure a coordinated program of development, I request our development partners to ensure that funding is channeled through our budget. The government also continued to receive support from local non-state actors such as churches, who are cooperating with us in the areas of health and education. Several NGOs are also operating in a wide range of activities, including environment, health, education, and rural development, to mention a few. We thank all our partners for working with us to make improvements in these critical areas.